Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a rounded scalloped edge around a circle or other shape. And I'm going to show you two ways. The first is for Adobe Illustrator CC, and then the second way is for CS6 or older versions. All right, let's get started. Okay, so here we are in Adobe Illustrator CC. First, we'll go to our shapes and choose the star tool. And I'm going to click and drag. And while I'm still dragging, I'm going to hit the up arrow to give us a lot more points. So right now I've got a black fill and no stroke, and that's the way I want it. I'm going to hit Command Y and then hit A to get my direct selection tool. And now I want to deselect all of these little points in here, but leave the ones out here selected. So I'm going to hold Shift. I'm going to come out here and draw a box around all these points in the middle. Now this could be a little tricky if you're not used to it, but if you mess up and select one of these, you can always just hold Shift and draw a box around it too. Okay, so right now I've only got the outer points selected. We have these little circles that are right inside the points, and those are actually corner widgets. So with my direct selection tool still selected, I'm gonna pull those in like this. I'm going to pull them as far as they'll go. And now I'm going to hit Command Y again. When you hit Command Y or Control Y, that shows you the outline mode. So it's just a different view of what you're seeing, and it makes it a lot easier to select things sometimes. So that is the first and easiest method of creating scalloped edges around a shape. Now, if you don't have Creative Cloud or you're still working on CS6, you may not have corner widgets like that. I can't remember if it's in CS6 or not, but now I'll show you another way to make the same thing. So this time we're going to click on our shape tool and choose the ellipse tool. And I'm going to click and drag holding Shift to get a perfect circle. And then I'll hit the letter D on my keyboard to get a white fill and a black stroke. So now I'm going to come over here to my stroke panel. If you don't have this open, it's under Window and Stroke. And then you might not have all the options that I see here. So if you don't, come over here to the flyout and go to Show Options. First, we're going to increase the weight of our stroke to 15. Then I'm going to make the cap round, the corner round. The align stroke should be set to the center, which is this first one. And now we want to make a dashed line. And you can see this already has started a scallop. Your dash should be 0, and then your gap can be whatever number you want. So right now, obviously they're not touching, so that's not going to work. I'm gonna move this back down to, we'll do 14. Another thing that's good to do is to make sure this is set to align to corners. So make sure this one's checked and not this one. Okay, now let's go to Object, Expand Appearance. Then we'll go to Object, Expand, and we'll make sure Fill and Stroke are both selected and say OK. And now all we have to do is go to the Pathfinder palette and choose the first Unite one. And now you'll have your scallop shape. If you want the scallops to be bigger like this, you can change your settings in the Stroke palette. So let's do another one. Hit L on your keyboard to get to the Circle tool. I'm going to Shift and drag to get a perfect circle. Hit D on my keyboard to get a white fill and a black stroke. We'll come over here to the weight and make it 15 like before. Make sure cap and corner are set to the center and choose dashed line. Make sure your dashes are aligned to corners. We'll increase the stroke weight. I'm going to hold Shift and push the up arrow. The gap I'm going to increase by holding Shift and pressing the up arrow. And as you can see, it's starting to look a lot like what we have up there. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. So let's go to Object, Expand Appearance, and then Object, Expand. Say okay, and then come down here to Pathfinder and Unite. Let's try something new and combine the two methods. So I'm gonna choose the star tool again. I'm going to make that same super pointy star. I'm gonna hit D on my keyboard, increase my weight to 10 points. Make sure we've got cap and corner in the center, dashed line, make sure we're aligned to corners, and then we'll move that gap back down. And now you can see we've got scallops around the entire star shape. Let's increase the weight a little bit, and then we'll increase the gap some too. We'll go to Object, expand appearance, object, expand, and then combine with the Unite tool in Pathfinder. So I just wanted to show you what's possible out there. You can get pretty crazy with it. And that's it. Okay, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click on the like button. And if you're having any trouble with this, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.